أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Brothers and sisters, while you're coming forward to present your questions, I would like to draw your attention to the envelopes which you found on your seats. The contents of the envelopes are very important, but I would like you to, in particular, pay attention to this leaflet. Sheikh Ahmadinejad's message to you today is Utu Sabin Rabbika Bihikmi. Call them to the ways of thy Lord with hikmah and beautiful preaching, with wisdom and beautiful preaching. This leaflet outlines IPCI's National Dawah Program. I would like you to take part of it. This is a very comprehensive Dawah Program, and it gives you the opportunity of approaching your friends, neighbors, and whosoever wishes to acquire more information about Islam. But in order to be able to talk to them, you have to have certain knowledge. So now, how do you acquire that knowledge? And here is an opportunity for you, one of opportunity, to acquire this book as advertised in the leaflet in the envelope for $4.99. But here is a one of opportunity to acquire two, to buy two for the price of one. If you go outside this exit, you will find a display and a store on your way out. If you were to use this exit, then you'll have to walk around, and there will be people to guide you where the store is maintained to sell these books. Brothers and sisters, after the questions and answers, please remain seated, because inshallah we shall conclude this program with a dua, with a supplication, inshallah. First question.
I will let God take that. I will allow the study at home and battle together.
Are we allowed to study
the Quran and Bible together, being a Muslim? Thank you.
My dear brother, you don't have to read the Bible, you don't have to study the Bible. But, if you are living in an environment where the people only know one book, every person you meet is a one-book professor. He will tell you anything you talk, discuss. He will say, whatever you tell him, he says, my Bible says this, my Bible says that. My Bible says this, my Bible says that. And what are you going to say? I don't believe in the Bible, I don't believe in the Bible. My Quran says this, my Quran says that. The guy says, I don't believe in the Quran. What are you going to talk? He says he doesn't believe in the Quran, and you say I don't believe in the Bible. No communication. So Allah is telling us in the Quran. وَقَالُوا, and they say, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُدًى أَوْ نَصَارَى. That you Muslims will never enter Jannah. There's no heaven for you. Unless, says the Yahudi, you become a Yahudi, a Jew. Or unless you become a Nasara, says the Christian. That is what Allah says. And that is the fact. The Christians are coming and knocking at our doors. And they, I want you people to put up your hand that this, there is a Muslim here whose house, whose door has not been knocked by a Christian yet. No Christian has ever come to your house yet to knock at your door. Please put up your hand. I want to see how many of you are here that you have been saved from the Christian coming along and harassing you. Put up your hand. Not one. You understand my English? That no Christian has come to your house yet, knocking at your door, to talk to you. Is there anybody here? No. 100% of our people are being harassed. And how are you going to talk to them? You've got to know something about this religion. So Allah says, "Qul, tell them how to burhan." Whatever the guy claims, he said, Jesus is God, this is your burhan. Christ died for your sins, this is your burhan. Sin is inherited, this is your burhan. Your proof. Allah is telling you to ask him for proof. So he produced it. He said, yeah, here's my proof. So what do you decide? Don't touch it. Huh? Allah is telling you to ask him for proof. There is a certificate. Like you're going to Makkah, and halfway there is a police post there. They stop your car at times. You say, Ikama. You know Ikama? This is your passport. And you don't understand what the hell is the guy talking about. You take out your diary. And I give it to him. He says, I don't touch it. It's very funny. You ask for Ikama, I give it to you. But if he picked it up and looks at it, and he gives a broad smile, he says, look, this is a diary. I have an Ikama. I don't understand. So he tells another guy, they say, tell him, passport. So he said, hey, here was your passport. I said, oh, like that. When I present him something, whatever it is, bloody rubbish, he's got to handle it. Because you're asking for it. I want your passport. So here. Yeah. So this is having a good laugh. He said, this guy's a bloody fool. Simpleton. He's a simpleton, you see. This is a passport. This is Ikama. I said, no. Ikama. I still don't understand. So he tells somebody else, tell him, Ikama. So he said, hey, passport. So Allah says, and anybody makes any claim, pull, tell them, ha tu burhanakum, in kuntum sadiqin, if you are speaking the truth, let us have a look at your proof. And there is no better way to fight the enemy than with his own weapons. Try otherwise. You are making a fool of yourself. And we are not talking, you know why? Because you don't know what to talk about. We are at cross purposes. He's talking about the original sins, you don't know what the hell that is. He's talking about redemption, you don't know what the hell that is. We don't know, so you don't know what to talk. You can say you're going to go to hell, he says you're going to go to hell. He says your book is false, he says your book is false. No. You have to learn to reason. The way I was doing tonight, I said, look, this is what your book says. Your Pope says that your religion is anthropological, and now look, I prove to you what he means. If you didn't understand, I show it to you. He means that God is like a man. If that is your idea, if is that what you want, go ahead. You want to worship a man God, a God who looks like a man, who hungers and thirsts? That's your business. You have freedom, choice. But there is no better way, my brother. If you can, by all means, but you are not. Every Muslim is not supposed to study the Bible. It's not for everybody. But the guy who wants to do the job, you need that weapon. Without that, you can't do the job. No alim can do the job, I'm telling you, if he doesn't master that enemy's weapon. One at a time. What do we do? One question from the male, one from the lady. Okay, one at a time. One. To be fair. Now let me finish. The Prophet, peace be upon him, never addressed other religions in an aggressive nature as you do. Do you think your approach to spread and understand Islam is better, or the Prophet's amicable and courteous nature to others, other faiths? Right. Now, our sister, she has a right. She has a right to have her opinion, to say that I am in an aggressive nature as you do. I don't know when you speak the truth. It does sound militant. It might sound offensive. And we are told in the Holy Quran that our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best example. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. So most certainly in the Apostle of Allah, you have the best example. You accept? Can you differ with that? Allah is testifying that in the Prophet of Allah, you have the best example. But do you know that the mushriks of Makkah took offense against his preaching? Do you know that? Do you know his own people, they loved him. Before he made his pronouncement of Allah's wahdaniyat, Allah, they gave him a title, As-Sadiqul Wa'dul Amin. As mushriks, they gave this title to our Nabi, that he is As-Sadiqul Wa'd, the person who is true to his word, is Al-Amin, he is the truthful, the sincere, the faithful. This is what they called him. As soon as he opened his mouth about Allah's wahdaniyat, they wanted to kill him. It sounded offensive. This one is aggressive. He sounded militant. Look, the best of mankind, the best example is creating offense. Maybe he didn't know how to talk. Maybe you know how to talk. Our alims know how to talk with hikmah. He didn't know hikmah. If you were there, would you have told him, Ya Rasulullah, you know Allah says in Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 1.